You can use Microsoft Word to print a single envelope, whether it's related to a file or not. Let's explore this now. Step one will require you going to your printer and loading the envelope the proper way. Look at your printer, and if you've got a specific tray for handling envelopes, excellent, you can load them into the tray and you're ready to go. But most printers require envelopes to be fed manually through the manual feed. In this case, you'll look at the manual feed area for a diagram. It should tell you whether or not envelopes should be face up or face down, whether they should be placed on the left side, the right side, or the center of the manual feed. And once you've got your envelope loaded properly, you're ready to continue. In Word, we click the Mailings tab on the ribbon and select Envelopes from the Create group. With the Envelopes tab selected, all you need to do now is type in the delivery address. So go ahead and type in your own address. I'm going to make one up to myself. Just press Return to start a new line. And once you've got your address input, there are some options to consider. Do you want to include the return address? If you do, make sure the Omit checkbox is deselected. In the preview, you'll see the area where the return address will appear, as well as the area where the delivery address will appear according to the default settings and options. Also, you'll see an icon representing the feed, and we'll want to change these options to match our printer. For example, we could click Feed to go directly to the envelope options with printing options selected. Now, for my particular printer, I need them to be face down, so I'll select face down, and they'll be fed on the right-hand side of the manual feed, so I'll choose that icon. Now, down below where it says Feed From, I have automatically select, which is the default, but if you have a specific tray for handling envelopes, you'll see it on this list when you click the drop-down button. I'm going to leave mine at automatically select and click OK. Now we can also change where the address and return address appear on the envelope. We could click the preview or go directly to both options by clicking the options button. Notice we're back to printing options, but we can select envelope options from here as well. So you'll want to match up the envelope size. I do have a size 10 envelope inserted into my manual tray, but when we click the drop-down, you see a number of other choices to choose from. Once you've got that selected, you can then adjust where the delivery and return addresses appear on the envelope, and you'll always know from the preview down below where they're going to appear. So from the left and the top, we can adjust where the delivery address goes. With auto selected, you can see the end result. But if you want to be more specific, you can use the up and down arrows or simply type in an actual value. So from the left, let's use the up arrow. As we continue to click the up arrow, you can see in the preview the address is moving across. And perhaps you want it to be about 3.5 inches over from the left-hand side. We can adjust the top as well. Using the up arrow, we can bump it up, which moves the address down with each click. Same thing goes for the return address, and for both of these addresses, we can also change the font. For the delivery address, I'm going to click the font button and change this to an Arial font, which is a little bit plainer. I do see a preview down below, and I can add font style, change the size, I'm going to change this to 11 points, and use any of the effects I might be used to using when working with regular text in Microsoft Word. Once I've got them selected, I click OK. And the font changes have been applied to the delivery address. We could then do the same thing for the return address if we needed to, but let's click OK. So now we're ready to print this out with the envelope already fed properly and our options matching how we've loaded up our envelope. We're ready to print. Click the print button and off it goes. So without opening a file or creating any related file, we are able to print out a single envelope using Microsoft Word.